the Medicaid program based on the gross cost, the part that the state has to chip in. But why are those savings necessary if on net, according to the student group, the private option saves money?
Well, it saves money during the next 2 years. I think it's 2017 or 18.
Just to clarify, the student group report says it saves money through 2021.
It will eventually cost us money. The Stevens group agrees with the figures that I outlined that you need $167 million each year to avoid dipping into general revenue. So the consensus on that figure, and that's what I can tell you.
You didn't mention that.
From the lockout.
I said today that we need accountability to make any provision that we put in. So that's how I expressed it. And that's not really appropriate. Sometimes they use pitch phrases, and that does not really describe what we need to do as a state. Accountability is the key. I've always said incentives are better than punitive measures. And you don't want, as I said today, at least the economics that are here. So I've indicated legislators that are expressing concern about that. We'll work very hard to get the right accountability for those type of premium.
Does that mean pursuing a lockout or not?
You said what I said.
Right. Talk about how you bucked other southern governors and took on political risk to push for continuing with this expansion. How did that play out in your head, and how did you arrive at the decision that was the best for the state of Arkansas?
The best tradition of Arkansas leaders that you set aside everything else and say what's the right thing for our state and the people of Arkansas. And, in this instance, both from a budget standpoint, to accomplish our objectives is important, but also from the standpoint of really the benefit to our members of health care, access to health care. And that's very important to us whenever you're trying to achieve the objectives of a healthy, active Arkansas. Access to health care is important. It's a major difference for us.
So are you looking at a special session after the
I guess that is the no, it's the timing. As I indicated, January through March through April, we're really working with CMS and refining what our waiver would look like. And then when the legislature meets, the timing would be appropriate, more like April. As I said, in January, I announced a specific time frame.
And all the $843 million, just to clarify, what you're asking for today is for the legislature to approve of generally that framework. But the question of whether it will be managed care or something else is going to be up to further discussion by the task force.
That's correct, correct?
Is there a certain from each of the provider groups, is there a certain amount of money or percentage of that $835 million?
Yes, it's really started with some of the recommendations of the John Stevens group, but as you can see in my outline, each one has agreed to a certain element of savings. And we're independently verifying that. We actually just need more time to continue those discussions and to work with the legislature to make sure that they are credible.
All right, guys, one more question.
Did you urge Congress or people voting in the primary to support some kind of program to continue Medicaid expansion? Republican congressmen want to kill Obamacare, including Medicaid expansion funding. Do you think federal Medicaid expansion funding is the new norm?
I don't think there's any norm out there. I think every state's handling it differently under their unique circumstances. Everybody thinks it's inconsistent to oppose Obamacare at the national level, but then participate in Medicaid expansion. You can make that argument if you wish, but obviously if they do away and make changes with Obamacare at the national level, then they're going to have to find replacements and solutions to address what all the states are doing to give more flexibility to states. So,
would you want the replacement to include Medicaid expansion funding?
We're dealing with the cards that have been dealt to us. And right now, it is the Medicaid expansion population in Arkansas under the framework that the previous administration gave. We're making the best decision for Arkansas right now. If Congress makes different decisions, we'll deal with those circumstances at that time. Thank you all.
Thank you.